Welcome to another Digital Anarchy tutorial. I'm Tor Olson, Software QA here at Digital Anarchy, and today we're going to take a look at Adobe Premiere Pro and how our plugin, Flickr-Free, works within it. Flickr-Free is our deflickering software plugin. It works to get rid of a laundry list of flickering problems that you might get from time-lapse footage, shooting with fluorescent or LED lights, archival footage, as well as slow motion. And right off the bat, we're going to take a look at the two most common problems that are associated with Flickr, which are from fluorescent lights and LEDs. So right here, I have an example of the flickering that you get from fluorescent lights. And this strobing that you see on the screen here, this is caused by when you're shooting fluorescent, what happens that if your shutter speed is out of sync with the refresh rate of the light, you get this out of sync flashing that's happening on the walls and the ceiling of this refrigerator right here. And so this guy is refreshing at a rate of 60 hertz, and the camera is shooting with a shutter speed that is not a multiple of 60, and that's why we're getting what we're seeing there. So we're gonna add Flickr Free right on top of that footage. So if I just go into my effect window and find Flickr Free under the Digital Anarchy Video Effect folder and apply it to our footage, we'll be able to see our interface right here. So this is Flickr Free itself. It's very simple. There's not a whole lot of parameters here. The whole idea behind Digital Anarchy products is that if you buy a piece of software, it should just work. You really shouldn't have to go watch a bunch of tutorials and go through a bunch of parameters that you don't understand. It should really just be very easy. And because of that, we made it so that you don't really have to go through a lot of these parameters. All you should really have to do is worry about this first one, which is the dropdown. Any potential problem of Flickr you're having will be covered in this list. So the default is time-lapse, but really we're trying to get rid of the Flickr from this fluorescent light by shooting slow motion. So in this case, I would choose slow motion. And it's fairly straightforward. I'm just going to bring this in and out points, or these in and out points over here, and render out what we've got. And right off the bat, you can tell that we were able to get rid of that flicker that we had before. Pretty cool. So how did we do that? How does Flickr Free work? And what is going on behind the scenes to be able to get rid of that flicker? To answer that, we're going to take a look at these different parameters down here below the preset menu, and I'm going to just go ahead and explain each of them to give you a better understanding of how Flickr Free is doing what it is doing. To start off, we've got sensitivity. Sensitivity is a parameter that governs how much of the frame we're looking at. In this case, we're really only having to look at a portion of the frame, namely the ceiling and wall of this refrigerator. And it's only taking up a portion of the frame, so we really don't need to crank up that sensitivity level too high. In this case, a value of 10 would work. For something like time-lapse footage, we might want to crank this up since pretty much the entire frame is being affected by the flicker when you're dealing with time-lapse. So again, sensitivity is governing how much of the frame we're looking at for our flicker. Next comes time radius. Now, this is one of the more important parameters when it comes to Flickr Free. The way that Flickr Free works is that it uses frame interpolation. We're taking a look at the frame we're looking at right now, and we're taking a look at a certain amount of frames before the one that we're looking at and after. We look at those frames, we find what the variances in brightness are, and we average them out so that we get a much more consistent look, the way we were getting down here. So, to go back to time radius, what this number means is that we're looking at 6 frames before, and 6 frames after the one we're currently looking at, for a total of 13 frames. Now, of course, this also means that the higher this number is, it maxes out at 10 right now, the longer our render is going to take, because it's going to have to look at more frames and look at the light and color values of those frames to try and average out the light differences. So that's something that's very important to keep in mind when you're regarding this number. Next comes the All Channels checkbox. What this means is that Flickr Free is looking at the red, green, and blue channels all individually when it's regarding each frame. And there really isn't a reason why this should be off. Flickr Free just doesn't seem to work as effectively with it off, so this checkbox should always be checked. Next comes Threshold. Now, Threshold is important because it's telling us how much of a range in pixel brightness is designated as Flickr. So depending on the percentage, a wider range of brightness values is going to be taken into account when Flickr Free is looking for the flicker and getting rid of it. Lastly comes Detect Motion. Now this checkbox exists because we're using frame interpolation, and so sometimes when you have something that's moving very rapidly through the frame, Flickr Free can mistakenly identify it as flicker and try to correct it. And when that happens, you sometimes get this haloing or ghosting effect. It almost looks like if you were to sweep your hand across the frame, it would look as if you have after images of your hand trailing behind it. What's important to note is that Flickr Free works best when Detect Motion is unchecked. So when you're adding Flickr Free to your clip, you want to have Detect Motion unchecked, see if you're getting the ghosting effect with any of the images that are moving through the frame. And if you are getting those after images, then you should turn Detect Motion on. But that's really it for the parameters. Again, we can take a look at the results that Flickr Free was able to show off. Go ahead and play that video, and you can see what it looked like before and what it looked like after. It's a fairly significant change. Now, I want to show an example of something that's related to the strobing that we're getting here with these fluorescent lights, because they are refreshing at a rate of 60 Hz. Over here, in this other timeline that I've created, we have a similar problem. If I actually create some in and out points here, so we'll be able to loop the sequence, you'll be able to see the problem that we're having right away, which are these rolling bands, and this is caused by LEDs, their refresh rate being out of sync with the shutter speed of our camera. And over here, in this clip that I have, if I just create some in and outs there, we'll be able to see that the flicker that we had that made that footage otherwise unusable is now crystal clear and pretty. If we go over to the parameters, you'll be able to see that the parameters are a little different. We've brought up the time radius and the sensitivity because we know that the frame is pretty much always being affected. These rolling bands are happening very, very frequently, so we want to bring that time radius up from 6 to 8 in this sequence. Additionally, if we look at the sensitivity, we've gone from 10 to 3 because the variances between pixels is very, very small. Between these horizontal stripes we saw when we played the original source material. Also, sometimes Phil will be moving his head in the shot, so we want to be able to turn Detect Motion on so that we don't get any of those ghosting effects that we were talking about before. So finally, we're going to look at some footage that Flickr Free was built for originally, which is time-lapse. Here we've got an example of the beautiful Golden Gate Bridge during sunset. And if I go ahead and play that, you'll be able to see the flickering that we're... you'll be able to see the flickering, that we're getting here, which is pretty distracting. And what this is caused by is mechanical error on the part of the camera in something called metering. What's happening is that when you're shooting time-lapse footage, you want to have your camera in aperture priority mode. And what this means is that the camera has a fixed aperture and you're telling it to decipher what the shutter speed should be in order to make the lighting look consistent. The problem with that is that the camera is imperfect and its interpretation of what is supposed to be consistent lighting isn't always correct. So instead of having a shutter speed that changes consistently over time, you'll have a shutter speed that starts and stops. And that's why we're getting the flickering that we're seeing here. Now, if I bring this over here, and if you've been paying attention to the parameters over here, you would have already noticed that we want to have the entire frame being affected, so we've bumped up sensitivity up to 30, because we know the entire frame is being affected by this flicker. There's really not a whole lot of motion going on other than the boat that's going through the channel here, but really it's not enough to trigger the ghosting effect that we were talking about. So if I go ahead and play this, you'll be able to see that we have a much more consistent looking sunset. The lighting is very, very beautiful, and we're not getting those starts and stops in lighting that we were before. So that gives us kind of a rundown of all the parameters and how they work together in order to have flicker free, find the flicker, and be able to get rid of it. But really all I did in all these instances to get rid of the flicker was go to this preset menu and choose the solution to the potential problem I had. And that's what's so great about flicker free. It's very, very easy to use. But that's really it for flicker free, its parameters and how it works. If you want to check out Flicker Free on your own footage, you can go to our website at digitalanarchy.com, and we've got free watermark trials there as well as other plugins and other goodies that you can play with. So, thank you for watching. Again, I'm Tor Olson, Software QA here at Digital Anarchy, and we'll see you in the next tutorial.